Introduce you the available traffic management strategies within the Aimsun Next traffic modeling software. We will create policies for changing the destination of vehicles in response to network conditions and events. We will define strategies and policies to divert traffic, close turns, and mitigate congestion. This will involve police actions, variable message signs, traffic control plans, and conditional triggers. Finally, we will create periodic incidents in a road section.
So today we will go through the hands-on exercises with respect to the managing traffic tutorial in the Aimsun Next software. We will focus on a scenario which involves the end of a football match game in Barcelona Stadium, the famous Camp Nou Stadium. So the game started at 6 p.m. and ended around 8 p.m. The simulation that we are interested in is from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. When the match is over, the vehicles leave the stadium as soon as possible at around 8 and 10 p.m. So our task is to see if all the vehicles can leave in a timely manner and how we as transport modelers can mitigate their impact on other traffic in the network. To open the tutorial Managing Traffic, I will need to go on the tab Tutorials. From the drop-down menu, select the Managing Traffic tutorial. Here, on the bottom of the page, I can see that I can open the documentation where I can find written the whole text of the Managing Traffic tutorial or follow this video that explains step-by-step the whole hands-on exercise. Next thing is to open the initial network. I will press the button here and a new dialog, which is called Select Existing Directory, will pop up. I need to select the folder where the network and the rest of the files should be saved. So I will select my desktop and I will select this folder. Here I see the Camp Nou Stadium and the car park centroid, which has one entrance and one exit. So vehicles will try to leave from this centroid and enter to the network. For this specific tutorial, we will need to regenerate the Aimsun path assignment file that is being loaded in the beginning of the dynamic simulation. To do so, I will go on the macro assignment scenario that is created already and check if in the outputs to generate tab on the path assignment, the keep in memory option is activated. I will press OK, and then I will go on the macro assignment experiment where I need to specify the object to generate, and in the path assignment option I will activate the store path assignment and I will check the path assignment 2373 object. I will press OK, and this is how I can run a static assignment simulation and save the paths in the end of the simulation. I will run a traffic static assignment and my paths have been saved in the new directory that I saved my tutorial. For more information on the macroscopic simulation, please wait to see the tutorial macroscopic modeling. So now we can start with the exercise number one, which is called reviewing post-match traffic demand. First, we will open the traffic management model. Under normal conditions, we have a traffic demand that is being represented by the object, which is under the folder demand data, and it is called traffic demand normal. If I open this traffic demand, I can see that it lasts from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. To generate the traffic demand that includes the post-match related traffic, the initial model contains a user class named CarSoccer. This user class models the extra load created by the fans as they leave. So the user class CarSoccer. I will open the traffic demand match to see the difference. So the main difference between the normal and match demands is shown below. The vehicles from the Camp Nou Centroid will queue in the stadium car park and exit as soon as there is an opportunity. To simulate this, in the experiment named MicroExp Match Nou Strategy, we use the arrival type ASAP on the Arrivals tab. The specific centroid, we will use the as soon as possible arrivals distribution so that it represents the behavior of drivers when the match ends and they need to leave the stadium and go to their places. To do so, I will need to go on the experiment micro expats no strategy, head on the tab arrivals, and here on the global arrivals, I will set up the global arrival type distribution, and arrivals per origin, I can set up for the Camp Nou origin centroid, I can set up the arrivals type as soon as possible. Of course, I can add and delete any of these arrivals types per centroid that have been already set up. I will press OK. So to view the initial post-match situation, we need to run the simulation to generate the initial outputs. To do so, I need to go under the project folder, right-click on replication, no strategy, and run an animated simulation. The main difference between the run animated simulation autorun and run animated simulation is that the run animated simulation autorun will start right away, while the run animated simulation will simulate the warm-up period and then will stop in the beginning of the simulation and wait for the user to press the play button. So once the simulation has launched, then I can pause the simulation and go on the option stop at. I will go on the stop at 10 p.m. and then fast forward my simulation. Here I have generated two dynamic labels. One represents the virtual queue of the remaining vehicles and the other one the flow. So at 8 and 10 p.m. we can see that the virtual queue 1,198 vehicles and the flow is 0 vehicles per hour. I will fast forward my simulation on for the next statistical interval. To check what is the statistical interval set up for this dynamic simulation, I need to double click on the dynamic scenario base. Then I will head on the outputs to generate and check the statistics interval that has been set to 5 minutes. So I will check the options, stop at 8 and 15, press OK, and then fast forward my simulation. Now here I see vehicles running through that section. The virtual queue is set to 1,035 vehicles and the flow on this section is measured to 1,680 vehicles per hour. Now I will double click on the section affected to open the dialog of the statistics. So I see that a new dialog has been popped up, and on the various tab here I will select the time series. I will go on the variables and activate the maximum virtual queue for the simulation replication no strategy for all the vehicle types and go on the graph. Then I will fast forward my simulation and see how every 5 minutes the statistical outputs are updated on the graph. So on the y-axis I can see the variable maximum virtual queue, which is the number of vehicles, and on the x-axis I can see the duration of my simulation, which is from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. So even though the virtual queue in the Camp Nou drops from 1,200 vehicles to 600 vehicles in an hour of a simulation, this would not be enough, because at this rate it would take at least 2 hours for the vehicles to exit the Camp Nou stadium, which as a result is unacceptable. So that was the end of the exercise number one to illustrate the problem. To check further what is the waiting time in virtual queue, I need to activate the waiting time in virtual queue variable and go on the graph. Here I will see that the waiting time in virtual queue from 0 seconds in the beginning of the simulation has been increased to 2,600 seconds in the end of the simulation. It is obvious that we need to apply some traffic management strategies to avoid this from happening.